Alright guys, another demo strip tutorial for you. Before we do anything on the decks, I did have a Basil Fawlty moment earlier on. Let me explain. There's not many lights in here, and I had one of these without the flashy bit at the top and a light bulb on it. People watch this and they think I'm happy, and here I do. I start the video and finish it and that's it. But believe me, there are many Basil Fawlty moments before, during and after. This one was before, so I had the one of these. It's the different one though. It's exactly the same, but it's another one. It was over there, and partially my fault. I sort of put it in an awkward position, and of course, when you've got a small baby and everything's, you know, they're asleep and you've done everything, you can then concentrate on doing something like this. So it's like, yes, I've got some time to do something like this. So I had everything set up. It was like camera action. And the other light stand went, light bulb on the floor. That doesn't matter, it's the fact there's glass everywhere, so you have to pick the glass up. So I was hoovering the glass trying to get it, because it goes everywhere, doesn't it? And then I take it into the kitchen, and I think, right, what I'll do, I'll try and get the remainder of the light bulb off, and I get some pliers, and clink, and more glass goes on the floor in the kitchen, so then I have to get I have to get the glass up in the kitchen. And then that's when I had my Basil Fawlty moment. I said, right, you bastard! I took this, and I went, right, not this one, the other one. I said, right, oh, I said, right, outside, you're going outside. So I opened the window and checked it outside. keys. When we're mixing, lots of things, in fact, there's 1,001,000,000 things to take into consideration. One of the most important is keys. Now, how can I explain this so you'll understand? I'll do it in my way, which is punk and hopefully very easy to understand. Let's say we've got a key that's like this here. There it is. And we've got another one that's like that. If we put those two together, they look the same, don't they? Roughly. So theoretically, they'll work. They should work because they're the same. If all of a sudden I've got a key like that, and I try and mix in a key like that, nothing in it by the way, shame, then they're not going to work because they don't really look the same. Now let's imagine I've got a key like that, but all of a sudden we get a child's hand that's maybe a little bit smaller and we put it together. There's a very good chance it'll work because it's the same kind of key. It's not exactly the same, but it's similar. Let's say, for example, I get a huge humongous ogre's hand with hairs gripping all over the place, put it next to mine. It's not the same, but it's similar, so there's a very good chance that will work. So when we try and mix with keys, we need to take into consideration, will they or won't they work? How do they sound? How do they look next to each other? All right, we can't see them, but we can hear them. Now, we have major and minor keys. The minor keys will, when you listen to them and they're mixed, the sounds, the tunes are mixed correctly, all in the minor keys, they will give a sort of a low vibe. They'll make almost the mix feel kind of low, but, not meaning to contradict myself, if you keep them in the minor key and you slowly go up through the key scale, you will actually lift the vibe, even though you're playing minor keys. If, on the other hand, all of a sudden you play a key that's in the major scale, something that's very, very uplifting, a lot of gospel music is in the major key, then you will definitely lift that kind of vibe. Now, what I'm going to do here, I've got a track in the minor key and a track over there in the major key, and they're both near enough exactly the same. So I'll give you an example, because we all like a bit of a mix, don't we? By the way, see you at the BPM show, NEC 2012, very soon in fact. And by the way, I'll be on the DJ Tutor stroke light console stand, because I've been given the opportunity to let people try and put together one of the, well, you can't actually see it, but it's one of the XPRS light consoles. And during the course of the show, you can come along to the DJ Tutor light console stand and you can give it a go at trying to put one of these together. And if you're the fastest one, you will win, not one of these, you'll actually win a punked up Stylie. In other words, it's going to be pimped up big time, so you can win one. Free, gratis and for nothing. I'm pretty sure you won't get it on the day, but it will be sent to you. Right, so what we'll do, this tune here, this one here, by the way, is Moving and Shaking, and, oh, well, that one there. Shake Your Foundation Mix, Jackson Lowe. This one here is that one there. It's, hold on, move it again. It's KY's Groove, KZR unreleased version, HT0 featuring KRC. Sorry, my reading is atrocious and my spelling is atrocious as well. I can't spiel to save my wife. Done that one before, haven't I? So, right. So this one here, minor key, sounds uplifting, it is uplifting. But what we're going to do, we're going to mix something in the major key, exactly the same key, near it, well, it's the same key, but the difference is one is minor, this one, the other one is major, so a lot more uplifting. Little cardboard box, big fish, little fish, cardboard box. Sorry, okay, right, sorry, bring it back. Actually, that would have been very good if I'd spent more time on it. But again, for all the people out there who do that, don't give a monkey's. You know why? Because this is punk, and this is where I like it. If you want it absolutely perfect, then what I suggest you do is go and watch someone else who will possibly spend hours on a PC. Aren't they called mix CDs? Anyway. Right, so that is almost like a smooth transition-ish, a smooth-ish transition from one minor key to a major key. So you hear about some people talking about a jump. What is a jump? Now that's naughty, come on. A jump from one key to another is where we have a bit of a gap. So what we need to actually sort of play one track that could be down here, and then we go up to somewhere like that. Now, it's of course depending on the keys. When we do a jump, we can do a good mix, and then we can mix from one track to the other. Smooth mix, but there's still a jumping key. If we do too much of a separation of keys, that's when we need to do almost a cross from one bang straight to the other. Now, I'm going to do that in another video because we've already done 9 minutes and 15 seconds wasted of your life. I do apologize, but we will do that in another video, all right? So practice and enjoy, have some fun. And remember, you have got it in you as well to inspire and teach. We've all got it. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.